Hello learners, myself Dr. Jyoti Ahuja, and today I give my presentation on lesson note diary, the need and process of maintaining. What is lesson note? Lesson note is the main components of a detailed lesson plan recorded in brief. A detailed lesson plan prepared by a teacher can be used by other teachers also, but a lesson note prepared by a teacher can be used by him or her only. It is a brief write-up you plan to teach a lesson in one period in any class. Hence, a lesson note is essentially a personal note prepared by you for organizing your classroom activities. Lesson note may be stated as a brief summary of a lesson in a teacher's planner diary. A short evaluation of a lesson by the teacher who delivered it or by another adult who observed it. A message reminding a teacher to revisit some issue in a future lesson. It is a list of activities to be set by a substitute teacher to be done by a class whose normal teacher is absent. It is a teacher's worksheet to be monitored by a senior colleague, listening subject matter covered by the teacher with a class on a daily, weekly, or monthly basis. A lesson note can be written in one page. The following basic information need to be recorded in a lesson note. That is, date on which lesson note are delivered. Class, that is, standard of the class. It may be 5th, 6th, 7th. Next is period, that is, in timetable, which period is assigned to a particular class. Next is subject and topic of the lesson note and specific learning outcomes after teaching the or delivering the lesson notes. It required TLMS, that is, teaching learning method, that is, the process of teaching in which teaching learning methods are used, which type of teaching learning method are used. Specific learning activities. If collected from activity bank, the serial number of the activities, that is, order of the activities, which should be followed first, second, and third. Next is main questions facilitating teaching and assessment and tentative time required for each major activity. The following sample format may be used for writing lesson notes. That is, first we write date and second is period and in which class, in which subject and topic of the lesson note. In lesson plan, we discuss the brief outline of the contents presented and discussed. We also discuss that the lesson notes completed or not completed. And the discussion of third point should be reasons for not completion of the lesson. And the last one is any new idea emerged in the class, that is, activities or teaching method which we should involve to positive response of our teaching process. Now, what is a lesson plan? Lesson plan is a teaching tool that helps the teacher in deciding what to teach, why to teach, when to teach, and how to teach in classroom while teaching. A lesson plan is a written guide for trainers, plans in order to achieve the intended learning outcomes. It provides specific definition and direction on learning objectives, equipment, instructional media, material requirements, and conduct of the training. What is the difference between lesson plan and lesson note? Lesson plan is organization of the teaching of what is in the lesson note. And a lesson note is a written article of what would be taught to the students. Now, what is teacher diary and purpose of teacher diary? A teacher diary is a diary where a teacher records what happens in their classes and their thoughts about it. Teacher diaries are used as development tools. For example, after a class that went badly, the teacher makes notes in her diary about what happened, what she thought, and causes were, ideas about how to change them, and a short action plan. In a classroom, teacher diaries are a good way to start a course of development. That is, a natural second step would be peer observation, that is, getting another teacher to analyze the class in the same way. Purpose for keeping a teacher diary. According to Richards and Lockhart in 1996, there are two purposes for keeping a teaching journal or diary. The first is to record ideas and events so as to reflect on them later. This supports the author's memory and can inspire new ideas for use in future lessons. And the second purpose is that the process of writing itself helps trigger insights about teaching. Writing in this sense serves as a discovery process. This is also given by Richards and Lockhart in 1996. Importance of teacher diary. Why teacher diary is important? Because it complete record of all that a teacher does. That is, it records the teacher's activity on the whole teaching process. Second one is plan of teaching learning activities. And the last one is maintain with care, should be neat and legible so that it set as an example for the fresher teachers. Why should teacher's diary should consist of? First, teacher's diary should be included with weekly programs as shown in the school timetable. It also includes other extra moral duties assigned to the teacher. It gives the brief record what he has done from time to time. It also involves the entry of homework assigned to students. It involves the name of students she teaches class-wise. It also records the academic achievement of students. It involves the peculiarities of class or of individual students. It involves the remarks about daily or weekly work. It also records the class test, that is the achievement of individual students from time to time. How to write teacher's reflections or teacher's diary? In teacher's diary, some steps should be considered while we write it. First is about learning objectives. That is, the main aim of teacher is teaching. And before teaching, he or she sets his or her lesson plans objectives. And that objectives is, did the students understand what we did in the lesson? Was what we did too easy or too difficult? What problems did the students have, if any? Was there a clear outcome for the students? What did they learn or practice in the lesson? Was it useful for them? And the activities and materials that are related to teacher's diary are, what different material and activities did we use, and did the materials and activities keep the students interested? Could I have done any parts of the lesson differently? And the third part includes about the students, that is, were all the students on task, that is, doing what they are supposed to be doing? If not, when was that and why did it happen? Which part of the lesson did the students seem to enjoy most and seem to enjoy least? How much English did the students use? And the next is classroom management. Did activities last the right length of time? It means the time assigned to particular activity. Was the piece of the lesson right? Did I use whole class work, group work, pair work, or individual work? What did I use it for? Did it work? Did the students understand what to do in the lesson? Were my instructions clear to students? Did I provide opportunities for all the students to participate? Was I aware of how all the students were progressing? And overall, a teacher, after teaching the lesson plan, should kept in mind that if I taught the lesson again, what would I do differently? That is, if the result is positive, then it should be going on. And if required, immediate action or change in teaching methods, then what would I do differently? Teacher's diary should also include about the biodata of the teacher. That is, his name, his age, his class, his qualification, his residential address, etc. And it also includes the details of in-service courses and workshop attended. It involves teacher's personal and class timetable. It broad outlines of split up syllabus of a particular class. List of slow learners and steps taken for their improvement also mentioned in teacher's diary. Minutes of subject committee meetings or staff meetings are also included in teacher's diary. List of projects planned class-wise also defined in this teacher's diary. Books read by the teacher and recommended for students to read. Record of interested anecdotes. Participation of student in CCA also should be included in the teacher's diary. List of teaching aids prepared and used by the teacher for particular standard of class. Field trips planned by the teacher. Record of casual and earned leave availed by the teacher. Achievements and publication of the teacher if he or she have. Teachers' parents' meetings. Result analysis, that is, result annually or semester system. Result in percentage of a particular class. And activity plan, which is for the future purposes, also mentioned in teacher's diary. Submission process of teacher's diary. Teacher must submit his or her diary to the HM or principal and its frequency fortnightly and monthly. Ensure timely submission. That is, it must be submitted to their senior for particular time. Let us sum up. Lesson note is the best tool for documenting the flow of a lesson and its impact on students. Lesson note lets you track who is talking to whom, when, and for how long, and lets you jot handwritten notes about what is being said and what students are doing. Lesson note can also record photos of student work, and teacher's diary keep expected learning outcome as key focus. Thank you, students.